your Charlottetown Islanders. We would like to acknowledge the land upon which we gather is unceded Mi'kmaq territory, and the good prince of Rhode Island is covered by the historic treaties of peace and friendship. We pay our respects to the indigenous Mi'kmaq people who have occupied this island for over 12,000 years past, present, and future. We're reminded that the Beltline Center is a smoke-free property. We study tobacco and cannabis products is strictly prohibited. Fans also, during the game, please be aware of flying cocks and equipment. As the part of the game of hockey, fans rest to be on your guard at all times. The Charlottetown Islanders and the Beltline Center will not be responsible for injuries received from flying cocks or equipment. For everyone's enjoyment and safety, we ask that you please regain your seats until the stoppage of play or during the intermission. and gentlemen, please welcome your Charlottetown Islanders. Ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for the opening St. John Seagulls at defense number 2, Nate Timmy. At defense number 10, Joseph Daniello. At forward number 18, Vince Elliott. At forward number 79, Luca Benoit. At forward number 90, Kiefer Lyons. And starting the goal for the St. John Seagulls number 1, Patrick Lever. Let's start it off for your Charlottetown Islanders at defense number 7, Marcus Piercy. At defense number 77, Anton Topolnicki. At forward number 17, Lucas Romeo. At forward number 23, Matthew Butler. At forward number 27, Michael Holmes. Starting goal for your Charlottetown Islanders, number 35, Nico Boudreau. The linesman for this afternoon's team, Jack Robinson and Ryan Reed. The referees, Chris Invento and
ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I ask you to please rise in your ear for the playing of our national anthem.
Welcome back to Charlottetown Islanders preseason hockey here, where last night we're in Rustico. Now we find ourselves back in Charlottetown, home away from home. We are on the campus of the University of Prince Edward Island here at the McLaughlin Arena. Luke Much on the call for you for this one between the St. John Sea Dogs and the Charlottetown Islanders. Starting goaltenders first off for the St. John Sea Dogs. Newcomer, overage signee from the Ontario Hockey League, Patrick Lever, the 6'1", 185-pounder from Perth, Ontario, is going to look to really take this league by storm here and try to take the Sea Dogs all the way into the playoffs and more. Meanwhile, down to our left, the Islanders give the nod to 06 goaltender Nico Boudreau, played last year for the Contendo Northwood Moose in the NBPEI MU18HL, where he was 9-13 with a .341 goals against average and a .911 save percentage, a not a very strong Moose team. So definitely impressive numbers. Puck drop here and away we go. Islanders will control off the hop. It will be Romeo playing with Horth to start this one off. Horth will go down below the cage. Ionello's in on him. That one Hops up to Luca Benoit, too hot to handle, and fall back down to Ainello. Turnover, Romeo with a shot. That one steered aside by Levers. He's the goaltender who faces the rubber first in this one. Ellie has it. He loses that one to Matty Butler, though. We'll throw that one back, and eventually it makes its way back inside of the Sea Dogs' end, where the Islanders will get a chance for an early change here. It will be former Islanders. Kiefer Lyons got cut in one of the earlier waves of training camp. Maybe wasn't expecting it or elected to go back to Junior A, but St. John wanted him. They got him. Now here comes Reynolds down the wing. Sporting the C for this one. Drops that one off. Shot on by Reinhart. Loose rebound in front. Reinhart's on that one too. Turn to fire. Another try. Saved by Boudreau down low. Pucks back behind the goal. Now in front again. A shot on and another. Good save by Boudreau. And he looks to be shaken up here early on as that one caught him up high. We're going to have to bring out the athletic trainer here as early on, right off the hop, only a minute and 7 seconds in, Boudreau had to make a number of saves in a couple seconds. Usually you'd think that'd be a lower body injury, but it was the last try there that got up high on him on the shoulder area. And after playing just last night at a 7:30 start time, it's going to be Axel Zoslos who might have to get the gear on. He's getting the gear on now just in case. In a 4-3 overtime loss versus Halifax, it was the Islanders scoring a late goal. 65 seconds left to force that one into overtime. As Boudreau, that one might have just knocked the wind out of him. He's going to elect to stay into this one. We'll get a quick second to regroup here. Shediac native seems to be all right. As puck down, face off again. Another good save by Boudreau. As Flanagan overskates that one. Bielito sends that one down low. Peter Reynolds now for the Sea Dogs. Will take that one. Loses his stick on the back of the cage. Will have to take himself out of the play momentarily there. Bell now has that one hop over his stick. Right back in. Off the stick this time of the Sea Dogs 0-5 defenseman, Da Silva. Boudreau able to cover that one up. After watching last night's game, Islanders really want to tighten things up here on the breakouts. A lot of times yesterday versus the Mooseheads, they'd get into open ice and they'd just get jammed. Turn over and then back in come the Moose. So we'll see if they can tighten this one up. But right now they're looking to end the momentum here on this shift by the Sea Dogs. There's that hot glass here at the Carey Complex that we've seen throughout the years behind both goals, especially the Islanders right now where the Zamboni door is. Seen pucks rip off that high and back into the net off the goaltender's back, so definitely something to be careful of. This isn't Boudreau's first time playing here, though. Played against the Charlottetown Knights here for the past two seasons. Now it's going to be the Sea Dogs coming up into the zone with it, making a shifty move there was Beveridge. But the puck eventually trickled in on goal, and that one will be covered up. Beveridge coming from New Hampshire, East Kingston. Drafted by the Sea Dogs in the second round. Signed right away. And now he's here and flourishing. We'll see if he can keep it up. As once more, the Islanders try to break it out. This time, Tivy gets in the way. Over to Ainello. Ainello and Tivy playing a lot together last year. Looks like they'll stay together for the start of this game at least. Pierre Noel has a couche with him. That one's turned over. It's going to be Romeo cutting in close. Short side shot, but that one ricocheted off the back of the net, I believe, and up and out of play, or off the goalie lever, I believe, because faceoff will stay inside of the Sea Dogs' end here with 17:26. Left to go in period number one. To take this draw, Cole Huckins. Didn't see him yesterday. He had an off day, as did Evan Nicholson. For the Islanders, both have drawn in. Huckins wearing 12, and Nicholson will be wearing 18. And here comes 18 for the other side. Ellie shot on, good save. Boudreau, rebound hopped out inside of that slot area, but the Islanders were able to take it away. Here's Campbell, throws one to the offside. Trickles into the corner. Huckins tries to throw it up top. Get another chance to try to make something happen here. So that one goes over the stick of Maruna. It goes off the boards now, back down. Boudreaux let it slide past him, but beating the icing is Kiefer Lyons. Benoit's in on that puck for the Sea Dogs. Campbell gets it out for the Islanders, though, with help from Huckins, as now Maruna into the zone, in on a one-on-four. Benoit comes back to help. It'll be Pierre Noël now for the Sea Dogs. Trying to chip his way up throughout the neutral zone. As Michaud takes a slash. No call on that one. Reed Calder steps in. Wicked wrister there. Good blocker save by Boudreaux. It's again Pierre Noël. Will dish it over. Bielito sends that one into the glove side corner. As the Sea Dogs try to cycle it around. Beaulieu to Calder up top, covering for his man. Silva will make his way up. Calder will enter into the play down low, and he gets it. Now circling back up top. Sends it over to Bielito. He'll spin off of Alexi Michaud. Now Duguay. Nico Boudreau's former teammate in Contendo. Now back again together for the Island. Here's one of the Islanders' goal scorers, Charlatan Michel, yesterday. Ripped in the opening goal for the Islanders. He starts the breakout there, as does Marcus Kiersey. But the Sea Dogs going to put a stop to it. It's going to be Mateko, the big body power forward, who has it now. A walk-in, shoot, high save, Boudreaux. Another shot, that one misses the mark. It will be Reynolds. That's gloved down, though, by Hinkley. Reinhardt and Reynolds are in on him. Hinkley still. Bell trying to chip that one out with help. Can't do so, though. And Mateko will let it slide back and let his defenseman, the hometown kid, Matt McLean, go and get it. McLean will find his man, and it eventually falls up to Mateko. But offside is the call on that one. Reinhardt got a little bit too excited there, and we are going to have a whistle. Just past 15 minutes remaining here. 14:49 left to go in the opening frame here. Puck drop as we're on our way again. It's going to be Arsenal trying to break free on that one. He dishes that one off and pokes it ahead. Nicholson's able to get it. Walking in is Hinkley. Nicholson back in the corner again. Gives it to Arsenal, former Charlottetown Knights teammates. Now, working it down low are the Islanders. Walker will get that one up top to Voss, but Lever is able to glove that one up easily. He has a chat with Matt McLean before McLean goes off to the bench. Both goalies looking strong here. Boudreaux definitely the busier out of the two so far. And he's looked sharp. Ellie throws that one back. It will be Iannello. Now Horth trying to center one out for Romeo. That one's too hot to handle for him. As again now down low it goes to Horth. Really impressed with Horth last night. Showing a lot of improvement in the summer and a lot of strength. And he's showcasing that right now. Topolnitsky up top. Shot on. That one wouldn't fall. Down low it goes. Going to be Tivy taking a body check from Horth, as we showed. And here's Horth. Shot on. Good save, Lever. Rebounds loose, but spun around and swept outside of the zone. Boudreaux wants to come for it. Thought about it. Came out and just jammed on the brakes. Topolnitsky had to bail him out. Here is Topolnitsky. Behind the goal line. It goes. Butler's in there. Trying to throw that one across rink wide, but didn't have enough mustard on that one. Now it's going to be Šimek. Pavel Šimek returning forward for the Sea Dogs. Will throw one on the goal. Luca Benoit trying to scoop up that rebound. Make something happen. Pierre Noël comes in. Jams on the brakes. Curls back. Looking for help. Still looking for help. Still has it. Throws one down low. Bielito's there. Bad angled shot off the back of the net. It will be Lyons to Topolnitsky. Topolnitsky gets a shove there from his former teammate. No love lost. It'll now be Huckins in the zone. Something that Islanders have needed for a while, really, has been size. And Cole Huckins brings exactly that for the black and gold. 6'3", 193 pounds. That is exactly what this Charlottetown Islanders team needs. And you can tell that that was their goal drafting too. Owen Conrad, 6'2", 210. Definitely adding some size here in the island. Now it's going to be Maruna looking for Campbell, who finds the aforementioned Huckins. That one gets thrown down. Campbell will lay out his man Pierre Noel there, showing that maybe, hey, size doesn't matter. And here he is now, Ross Campbell. Crosses the red, is content to dump that one in, head off for a line change. Flanagan will come on for him as Bilodeau looks to set things up. Hands that one off to Lyons, but he had two or three Islanders on him, and that'll delay the breakout. As Michaud will step up on that Islanders forecheck. Brings it back, Flanagan now. Stopped up again once more by Lyons. Reinhardt now will look rink wide. Reynolds trying to give it back to Reinhardt. Voss follows that one in. He's able to stop that play. Not the most original way, but they don't ask how you do it. They ask how many, and right now it's one fantastic stop there for Isaac Voss. That puck got through. They were looking at a pretty good chance for the Sea Dogs. As Voss is on it again, Reynolds will be on him though. Coming in for that is Emoi. Up top it goes, Mateko covering on the point for Emoi. As Hinkley will step into one. It will be Flanagan to Voss now. Over to Hinkley at the red line here. Dishes that one off the boards to Michaud. Michaud looking inside, driving towards the goal, but a good cover up there by Lever on the sudden burst of speed by the Islanders and Kian Bell. Bell put up 102 points last year in the SJHL in 51 games. 54 goals, 48 assists. 102 points. Crazy. The Islanders certainly looking for him to continue that success. Obviously different league, different style of play. We'll see what he can bring to the table this year. So it'll be Arsenal trying to rev up a breakout here. Duguay sends that one back. He eventually looks up ice, finds his man. That one's turned right over and open ice to Shimmick, though. To Beveridge. Takes a bump there from Duguay. Arsenal will pick up the loose change. Has Nicholson with him. Arsenal into the zone. Brett had a couple good opportunities last game in Rustico. There's another one, that one. Just blocked by Tibby. Didn't see it, but he still got it. Shimmick will come back down the other way. One-hand pass in front. Backhand, and he hit the post. He had lots of room. Just couldn't get it in. Another try there. Boudreau really having to work for these saves here. Sea Dogs doing a great job of cycling the puck. Bad angled shot off the back of the netting again. Sea Dogs liking those high opportunities on Boudreau. 5'11" is Nico Boudreau. Been up to the task so far. As Iannello wheels back into his own end. Bilodeau has a couche with him. He'll just decide to toss that one in. Let Benoit go after it. He is Hinkley on him though. He's now the Sea Dogs turn that one over. Here's a stretch pass and into the zone come the Island once more. Backhand save, Lever rebound, scores! It was a Michael Horth breakaway and a rebound up in midair, and it's going to be the Blackhawks. Camp invite, Lucas Romeo batting that one into the open cage on Patrick Lever on an unorthodox play. Horth tried to go backhand. Lever got the first one. He couldn't get the second. And it's 1-0, just halfway through this first period. 9 minutes and 25 seconds remaining here at the MAC. First goal,
score number 17, Lucas Romeo. Assistant number 27, Michael Horth. Take number 7, Marcus Kiersey.
Here's Voss. He'll give that one up to Campbell. Campbell gets stick checked there by Bilodeau. Ellie in on the forward check. He's not afraid to go into the corners. Islanders are familiar with him. As now Hawkins, beauty of a feed to Campbell. Campbell has Maruna with him, just couldn't find him. as Hawkins lays out his man. Now Campbell again tries to center one out in front. That one off the glass. It will be Conrad stepping in from the point. Campbell up top to Maruna again. Shot on that one. Deflected off into the corner. Bilodeau to his man Benoit. Gloves that one down right along the half wall. There we come to a standstill here. And a penalty coming up. I believe it's going to be an Islanders power play here. I think Cole Hawkins got a high stick. Second one of the shift. The officials missed the first one. We'll see if it's... Yep, I'm pretty sure. Yep, it's going to be Bilodeau. He's going to head into the box here for the Sea Dogs. And he'll give the Islanders their first opportunity here at a man advantage in this one. The Bell in on the draw. Who will give that one over to Kiersey? To Campbell. Campbell gives over to Kiersey again. One time drive there. That one into the corner of Michaud. Now it'll be Kiersey to Bell again up top. On his offside, hands that one down low to Horth in the bumper. Bell again up on the half wall to Kiersey. Has a man open. He'll dish that one off. Bell tries to shoot that one loose in the crease. Hops back up. Kiersey a shot. That one blocked off in front by Pierre Noel. Kiersey again one more time. We'll give it to Bell. Kiersey gets it. One time try again. Low shot. Good save, Lever. As now again, the Sea Dogs will get to clear and get a line change once again. Another good shift here from the Islanders' first power play unit. Just couldn't get anything to fall for them. As Kiersey will start it up again. Having to dodge a neck guard there as he moves into the open ice in the Sea Dogs' end. Romeo will knock that outside of the blue line as the Islanders set up. It'll be Matty Butler up to Kiersey. Who has Romeo? Tries to find Flanagan on the inside. Butler again, Kiersey. Butler, he has space, tries to dish it inside to Flanagan once more. Still now, Kiersey up top, bobbles that one, keeps it onside. Romeo to Maruna, finds Flanagan. Butler, with a little bit of space on the half wall. Mateko on him, tries to go cross ice, just gets over to Romeo, barely. Michelle with a shot, that one. Tipped off of Mateko's stick and out of play up into the netting. We're going to have a face-off inside Patrick Lever's end of the ice with 17 seconds left to go here on the man advantage. 6:39 though in the period. That one gets cleared down. That will pretty much do it for the man advantage. As Voss will come around to collect that. He'll look up, find Walker, chipping that one into the zone. As a turnover in front, good save, Lever loose in front, puck's bouncing around. It's going to be Reinhardt, the first one to it as it falls onto the half wall. Lever without a stick, right behind the cage. He can't go back and get it yet, having to wait for his squad to clear the zone. Went back for it, and Nelly knocked it away. Now the Islanders have it again. Lever gets back up. Shot on top. Olnitzky off the stick of Ellie. That one. Just about some friendly fire there. Now down low, Campbell. On him is Da Silva. As a Kush. We'll give that one off. Too far in front of Matt McLean. Reinhardt. Dishes it up still. Da Silva in on goal. Shot on. Boudreau's down. Puck's behind him. No whistle. Good on the official there in proper position. Boudreau didn't know where it was, and it was just behind him. That would have been in if he stayed in between the posts. Now Hawkins takes a shot. Campbell one-timer. That one saved. Another shot on. Lever has it. Jams that arm to the chest protector, and he's able to just squeeze onto that one. As everyone's just wanting to let them rip here at the Bell Alliance Center. 1T after 1T. But we're still only at 1-0. Now it's going to be Beveridge off the draw. Wouldn't fall to him though. Lever will let that fall through his crease. Hand it off to Amoa, who moves that one up to Lyons. It will be Conrad back for it now, but icing is the call after an errant pass off the Sea Dog stick. We will have a whistle and we'll come all the way back down into the right side of the ice surface here. Here come the Islanders trying to reset their breakout here. Romeo moves that one in. It's going to be Horth giving it back to Lucas Romeo. He'll loop in, backhand that one over to Butler. Now it's going to be Horth again, rather. And now Beveridge, the 07 second round draft pick, draws the stick of Romeo in under his arm, and he'll grab a penalty and a power play for his squad. As it's going to be Lucas Romeo now taking a penalty. It'll be a hooking call on him. And with 4:10 left to go in the first period, it will be a 2-minute St. John Sea Dogs power play. As we see Reynolds, Mateko, Reinhardt, Bilodeau, and Ellie, the fourth forward, up on the point here for this one. While the Islanders look to go Topolnitsky, Campbell, Walker, and Kiersey. It'll be Reynolds off to Bilodeau. Reynolds gets it again on the half wall, up to Bilodeau. Back to Reynolds, back to Bilodeau, looking for that one-timer. Bilodeau will elect to shoot. That one missed the mark, though. Topolnitsky hard into the corner for that. Campbell watching on. Lost his neck guard, did Ross Campbell. Puck cops out in front, though. And as soon as puck gets out, he's going to have to go to the bench. It's going to be Reynolds now. Building up steam before handing that one off to Mateko. Dump it in. Boudreau tries to clear it out himself. That one took a funny hop, though. Lucky no one was in the QB position there in the power play for the Sea Dogs. Now Bilodeau starting up again. Reynolds crosses the blue to Mateko. Bilodeau, he'll walk the point from that fine line. Reynolds with space, walks in, backdoor feed, good shot, better save. Mateko left all wide open. I believe that was Conrad who lost his man. Boudreau stuck with it though, had the first pad save, got the second with the glove as he continues his impressive showing here. Now the Islanders able to win that draw back cleanly, and they'll send that one down the ice. As Lever will leave that one for Tivy. Ionella, the second unit out. Beveridge, cross ice feed, Akush. Danny Akush gonna look up top to Shimmick. Sneaky shot does Pavel Shimmick have. See if he can unload one here. Beveridge back up top. Tivy missed the mark with that. Now Shimmick again. Walks in, shoots that one. Missing up high to the blocker side. Shimmick again. Pressured though by Kiersey on the loose puck. Arsenal able to drop down to one knee, get that one out, and then go off for a line change again as we're back to 5-on-5 hockey here. It will be Akush coming up. Boss now steps in the way and breaks up that play. Campbell will give it to Hawkins, and they got room to work with here. Hawkins walks in, shoots that one off the toe of Lever into the corner of Campbell, who tries to give that one up to Isaac Voss. Instead, it's going to be on an odd man break back the other way. That one tight. A Akush shot on. Good save. Boudreaux got the rebound, too. A 3-on-2 turned on to a mini breakaway for Danny Akush, but Boudreaux, once again, had all the answers. Butler pulls that one back for the black and gold. Here's that one goes off the boards. McLean gets stick checked by Romeo, but draws a penalty, though, as his glove flew off from the stick check of Lucas Romeo. He doesn't like that one, and he's going to head off for yet another 2 minutes right after the first Islanders penalty kill. There's going to have to be another one here. As Romeo will sit for his second penalty of the game. Islanders will make sure to get their right combos out here for this one.
Islanders penalty number 17, Lucas Romeo.
Ellie has that one. Walker being physical on him, though, is able to get that one outside the zone. And a minute 15 left to go here, 75 seconds. See what the Sea Dogs can do as Reinhardt enters into the zone, looking to cross that one over. Can't do so. Stepping into that was Michaud, and he'll fire that one down. Head off for a change. A minute left to go here in period number one, as you'll hear. Now here comes the Sea Dogs. It will be Reynolds over the blue line. Dishes it off to Reinhardt in on goal. Shot on that one. Never got to Nico Boudreaux, though. And now Kiersey back the other way. Has Arsenault with him. Mateko's on Arsenault, though. That one just shot in on a dump, I'm going to say, for the sake of Marcus Kiersey. As now Reinhardt will try to enter in. Once again, though, Islander doing a great job of holding that blue line. Not letting St. John get in easily at all here. On the power play. There's Iannello now. One last rush here for St. John. 15 seconds left to go. They like to dump it in on the power play, and Hinkley will turn and fire that one. Tivy keeps it in, hands it over to Shimmick, who is Huckins on him, looking for Beveridge. Instead, it gets intercepted, flipped up, and back down, and that's where we will end period number one at, with 29 seconds left on the Lucas Romeo penalty for slashing. We started at 0-0. We will end the first at 1-0 after the man in the penalty box, Lucas Romeo, put his squad up by one. We'll see what he can do in period number two after this break.
Thank you.
Welcome back to period number two action here from the Bell Alliance Center on the campus of the University of Prince Edward Island. Luke Much here for the call between the Charlottetown Islanders and the St. John Sea Dogs, where right now the Islanders hold a 1-0 lead over the Sea Dogs on a breakaway rebound. A bat in midair from Lucas Romeo. Michael Horth tried to go backhand. Patrick Lever, the St. John Sea Dogs netminder, got a blocker to it. Rebound was floating up in the air. Romeo put the stick to it, batted it home. Shots after one, 13-13, dead even. Nico Boudreaux, perfect so far, knock on wood if you're an Islanders fan. As we get ready to go here for period number two, pegs are in the nets. We are all set, ready to go. Benches are standing up. We're ready here for second period action. Sea Dogs starting on a 20-second power play too. As Ellie comes in and he'll dish that one off to Reinhardt. They'll look to set something up fast here off maybe a set piece. They went for a hard rim, but no one was home, and that's going to pretty much neglect the rest of the power play with the forecheck of Campbell. He's keeping St. John in their own end here. And it's going to be Mateko coming up over the blue line as Romeo now exits the box. We're going to be back to 5-on-5 hockey. It'll be Topolnitsky with it. He'll backhand one, looking for Huckins. Couldn't get to him. He'll try it a second time. Still can't get it up. Instead, he'll bounce back in front of Boudreaux, and that's where Marcus Kiersey will be. Get that one poked away by Reinhardt. Stick check in there, trying to push that one outside of the zone. Now down low, here's Reynolds up top, quick shot, that one, save, rebound, that one's rifled through the crease by Reinhardt. Boudreaux wasn't there in time. Now it's Ainello, time and space, that one blocked by Huckins, putting his body on the line and flipping it up into neutral ice. Boudreaux getting a little lucky there, that block by Huckins, as now Reynolds will bust into the Islanders zone, that one thrown out inside of the goal, but not in any harm's way as the Islanders steer into the corner. Pierre Noel hops off the bench, hands one over, and a shot in by Beaulieu will get gloved down by Boudreaux, and he's going to hang on. Minute and 31 seconds into this second period. Flanagan stepping into that draw against Kiefer Lyons. Lyons will win that one. Carla Ten-Michel, first one into that puck. Reed Calder will step in, try to negate the Isles breakout, which he does momentarily. See if he can keep possession. It's going to be Bielidou cycling that one up. Now it's going to go up top to the point. Shot on tip there. That one off the bottom of the net. As Beaulieu gets pinned up, it will be a dog pile in the corner here as we have Pierre Noel cycling that one down low. Beaulieu looking for Calder. He's going to then look for Bielidou. Bielidou will dish that one off back to Calder again. Sea Dog cycling it well as they're going to look to continue here, but that one gets intercepted. Now here comes the Islanders back the other way. It's going to be Alexis Michaud stepping in, hands that one off to Bell. Bell will now look to move it up top to the point. It'll be Isaac Voss with it. Voss will walk the blue line, dish it off to Hinkley. He'll step in, look for the stick of Bell in tight. Can't connect, though. Nicholson with it now. Will dish it over to Arsenault. Up top to Voss. Over to Hinkley now. He'll walk in, give it back to Nicholson. On the half wall to Brett Arsenault. Arsenault will curl in, shoot, rebound down low. Nicholson just couldn't hammer that one home in time. And Pierre Noel trying to push that one up. Instead, it's going to be Voss that steps up and wraps that one around into the zone where Lever will drop it for his man, Bielidou. Bielidou will push it back over, and now it'll be Šimek. In front it goes. Pass Boudreaux into the corner. Arsenault is content to chip that one out. And so now Walker will go in for the loose puck. Šimek will step in, and here comes Beveridge. Still along the blue line. Sea Dogs do a good job to stay inside. Shot on, rebound up right out in front. As now It will be Walker, who looks to push that one in. Backhands it. McLean is the first one into it. Huckins will try to lay the body on him. Toe dragging around his man is Schimmick before he moves it up. Beveridge gets that poking away, though, as now McLean is going to get a second try here. He'll back that one over to Amwap. One-touch pass. Here's Beveridge. Belmare was trying to make something happen. Instead, once more, it will be Beveridge. As a penalty here now on Cole Huckins, as behind the play, he's going to get a cross-checking call as he goes after Egan. Beveridge all over the ice that shift, making all kinds of plays happen, and eventually he got in the way of Huckins, and Huckins just let him have it, and he's going to have to sit for 2 minutes here. And this will give the Sea Dogs their third power play of the game. Now, we'll set up. It'll be Ellie inside to Reynolds. Drops that one off. Shot scores! A beauty of a set play there. As they move the puck from left to right. And then a drop pass. Noah Reinhart all alone along that far-sided faceoff circle. He was able to rip that one on the low blocker side of Nico Boudreau. And just like that, we have ourselves a tied hockey game. Down to Silva. We'll give it off to Bilo, and he'll dump it in again. Back down behind the cage. It'll be Conrad trying to break it out here for the Islanders. Islanders looking a little bit flat-footed here to start off this second period. Not the same buzz that they had in the first. Now to Silva again. Give it off to Ellie. Wouldn't fall for him, though. Instead, back it goes. De Silva has Romeo on him. He'll lay the body. That one falls out in front to Bilodeau. He'll try to stop up. Instead, it's going to be Horth with it, looking for options. Tries to wrap it around in front. Never got towards Patrick Lever, though, or any intended Islanders players. It's Hinkley now with it. He'll cycle it up into the zone. Keeping it alive, only momentarily, though. De Silva has it now back for the Sea Dogs, where he finds Benoit. Over to Ellie. Ellie walks into the zone. Shot, low shot, good save. Rebound try, that one never got towards Boudreau in the goal for the Islanders. As Benoit again, open man Ainello on the offside, couldn't get it to him though. As Tibby will step up on Romeo, take him out of the play. Ellie overskated the puck, and he'll have to circle back into his own end where he dishes that one off to Ainello behind his own cage. Sea Dogs will start from there, crossing the red, dumping it in. It's going to be the defenseman, Nate Tibby, going after it. Rubs out his man along the boards. As now up with it is Flanagan. Flanagan to Bell. And it's going to be Kiersey walking in. Shot on. That one knocked the shaft of the stick of Patrick Lever out of his hand. Second time Lever's lost the stick. Puck up top again. Low shot. Good save, Lever. Scrambling there after he finally put the stick back into his blocker hand there. It's again now. Beaulieu. It will be still Beaulieu. In on the rush. Grabs it up behind the net. Tries to hand that one over to Akush. He's taken away and into the back wall by Flanagan. Kiersey's there as well. Pierre Noel steps up trying to make something happen. It's now Kiersey again. Will look to push that one up again once more. This time it's going to be Michaud busting through with company, though. Kiersey, one-time shot. Lever made the save at the top of the faceoff circle. Another one outside of the crease. These goalies, they love to gamble. Seen Boudreau out top before, and we've just seen Patrick Lever right out in between the faceoff circles there. Thankfully, no damage on either play as we get an icing call. 12:51 left to go in period number two. We are still tied at one each. The opening goal from Lucas Romeo. And then Noah Reinhart followed up with a power play tally. Nicholson wins it back. Arsenal steps in, shoots. Good save, Lever. Pushing that blocker. And it's now back to Nicholson again with space. Nicholson walks in, dishes that one back up. Duguay, he wanted the one tee, not in the wheelhouse. Waits, shoots, that one blocked, has it again, shoots again, low. Rebounds there, that one wouldn't fall for the Islanders though. Duguay has it again. Now over to Michel. Michel throws it down. Arsenal able to pick up the loose change. Nicholson. And Arsenal playing pitch and catch there momentarily. Nicholson will give it over to Duguay. Duguay up top. That one wasn't in the wheelhouse for Michel. Shoots it anyways. Just bounced a little bit wide. Nicholson in a foot race with Lyons for it. But it squeaks by him. And the Islanders are regrouping now. As Michel's going to start himself. This unit staying out here for the Islanders. They aren't done yet. It will be Walker, Arsenal, and Nicholson. As Hinkley now shot on that one low. And a glove saved by Lever as now... The Arsenal group will head off for the Islanders. The Hawkins group will come on. 11:50 left to go in period number two. A fantastic shift for the Islanders. Just couldn't make one count. As looks like there might be a hole in the net, maybe. Just one of the officials will scoop something. I'm not sure what it was. Something spilled, not sure. Either way, back underway. Here's Bilodeau. We'll try to throw that one up. It's turned over. Hawkins now walks in, shoots. High shot there on Lever. Shaken up with that. Making sure his helmet's all right. That one hit him right off the dome. Hinkley will lay the body on Belmare. As Maruna looks to shift up over the red. Now the blue. It'll be Hawkins to Voss. Voss back in his own end. Voss looking for Hawkins. Found him, but that one couldn't stay on the tape. It'll be Calder now. For the Sea Dogs. Egan Beveridge trying to corral that one back. Instead it hops back into the Islanders end. Boudreau out again to play it, but that one waved off for icing actually by Michael Horth with the hustle there. As Hawkins now throws it up top. Kiersey, that one just topped over his stick. And all the Islanders didn't touch it. We'll keep going. Bilodeau. Hands that one off. That was too many men there. Officials didn't call it, though. Toplinitsky from the top. Low shot there. Rebound loose. Lever had to scramble to knock that one away from a streaking Michael Horth, who would have had a dangerous opportunity there. Not for the stick of number one in white and blue. Now it's going to be the Sea Dogs here. Bilodeau looking to move one up. It's going to be Mateko, though, now for the Sea Dogs. But jumping the gun there was Pavel Šimek. And we're going to have a stoppage of play and a meeting of the minds. So we'll come back into play here into the Islanders' zone. As they try to break free, Iannella will pinch up and hand that one off. Ellie now gives it back to Joe. Joe Iannella. Well, move it across. Now here's a try. Tivy back door, that one. Wouldn't go for Kiefer Lyons. Boudreau was down. Lyons just couldn't get a good handle on it. Iannella blocks that at the point, but then it's chip free. It'll be Anthony Flanagan. Into the zone he goes. Islanders are familiar with him, Flanagan, on Team Quebec in the 2023 Canada Winter Games. See, Team Quebec, I believe they had either 4 out of 5 or 5 out of 5 of the top 5 picks in the QMJHL draft this year were from Team Quebec. They had a wagon of a team. Weren't able to get it done in the end, though. Now Iannella looking for Ellie. Couldn't find him. That one gets tipped in, but into the bench it goes, right past Axel's Oslo's. So 9:01 left to go here in the middle frame. Period number two. As we're going to drop the puck here again from center ice. Jack Robinson have the duty of doing that. Pierre Noël will try to push it through. Instead, it gets poked back all the way up to Moi. To Beaulieu. He's going to look cross-ice. That one didn't have enough on it, though, to find Danny Accouche. As Ben Moi will backhand that one down. Boudreau's out to play. It'll stop it on the forehand, rim it back up, looking for Walker. As Voss sneaks in there, tries to make something happen. Now it's going to be Pierre Noël for the Sea Dogs. Walking in still, Pierre Noël tries to dive one in there. That one looping in front of the goal. Couldn't find its way towards the mesh, though. As we're going to have a standstill here to the glove side corner of Nico Boudreau. Danny Accouche up top. Wasn't sure if that was intended for Matt McLean or the new Beveridge. Off the bench. Now it's going to be Danny Accouche back in again, trying to lay one down. Here is Beveridge, puck down in front of Boudreau. He couldn't get a hand to it. Ended up on his backside. He's back now, though. Accouche with it. He'll stop. That one gets blocked in front. Egan Beveridge waits for a man to come to him, then spins off him, dishes one in, cuts into the slot. Does Beveridge. Couldn't get a pass back, though. He's wide open. Now he takes a bump from Cole Huckins. That one gets thrown down, but Boudreau is able to slam the trapper over that, and he's going to hold on to that and get his squad a line change here. Here are the Sea Dogs. Trying to set something up. Long shot in. Good job by Boudreau. Able to absorb that one right into the crest. So we'll get another drop of the puck here. It will be Topolnitsky for the Islanders, who moves that one up to Horth. Horth will throw that one up, intended for Romeo. It'll bounce by him and go to Matty Butler, who tries to backhand that one in. Romeo does get there, backhands one himself towards the goal, but that is sticked and steered away by Lever. Butler again now, curls into the zone behind the post. It will be Matty Butler over to Topolnitsky, who's looking for Kiersey. That one hops over the blue line, though. And now Bellemare's in on him. In on Topolnitsky now. Good job by Topo to cut off that play. Very composed and cool, calm and collected there. Good poise on 77. Not getting too excited, just getting back into position. As puck comes out in front, it's fanned on. Open net, no Islanders within the slot area, though. Now it's going to be a two-on-one back the other way. Bellemare goes right by Duguay towards the goal. Gets taken down. Penalty shot. It's going to be Duguay got caught flat-footed. And, I mean, Chad Bellemare just wheeled right by him. And Duguay had to resort to taking a penalty. It's going to be a penalty shot here. Boudreau going to have to come up big again here.
Number 25,
Here's Bellemare. Walks in on his forehand. In on Boudreaux. Glove save by Nico. He puts the glove out, takes away the angle, and takes away the scoring chance. It's still 1-1 here at the McLaughlin Arena. Great job by Nico there, staying in the middle of his crease, keeping the puck square to that Islanders logo on his chest. And he was able to make that glove save. Didn't get all of it, but he got enough. Sent it into the corner. Conrad threads the needle there. Here comes Bell. Levers out of the net. Tries to clear it. He does. That's probably four times, two for each goal that we've seen come racing out of their net to play the puck. Now here's Bell again. And it's worked for them every single time, too. Sea Dogs and Iannello look to take it outside of the zone as Calder and company still tied up back there. I believe that's Michaud. It is. As now Bell back the other way. Looks for Michaud and he has him. Here's Michaud into the zone on Ellie. Tries to tuck one in, low blocker. Couldn't get it. Now a penalty here. And not a penalty shot. Going to be a hook here. So a power play for the Islanders. Michaud didn't have the clear two strides on him, so the officials have deemed that that's just going to be a two-minute minor. Now here's who we're going to throw out. They're going to bring out Arsenault, Bell, and Horth with Kiersey and Campbell. This man advantage, and here is Ross Campbell. Bill Campbell walking in, takes to the backhand shot, rebound Arsenault, couldn't put it away. Got stuck in his skates. Another good opportunity for Brett. Here's Kiersey, now Brett again. To Kiersey. There's that one cross ice. Campbell intercepts, shot on, rebound try. Good save on Arsenault again. Arsenault's knocking on the door here, he's due for one soon. Campbell on the half wall. Spins off Reynolds. Gives it to Kiersey. Kiersey to Bell. Bell to Kiersey again. Kiersey will give it over to Ross. Ross Campbell. Down low it goes. Wrapping. Trying to stuff that one in was Horth. Brett Arsenault with the try. Now Kiersey. Backdoor feed shot on that one. Couldn't hit the target. Off of the stick of Bell. Now another shot on. Doesn't work. Arsenault again. 58 seconds left to go. Half the power play killed off for St. John. They haven't had the puck once. Kiersey a drive. That one blocked. Turned to fire by Reynolds. Oh, just squeaks outside of the zone off the stick at Kiersey. That's a fantastic first shift on the power play, but still just can't get one to fall. It'll be Romeo. To Hawkins. Kiersey tries to lay one in again. That one misses the mark. Matty Butler's on it. Butler will give to Romeo. Butler, Kiersey up top, staying out. Maybe for the full 2 minutes. Here's Butler. Crosses it across, but that one just behind Huckett. Now Kiersey again. Tries to lay one in. That one gets tipped off. Trying to clear it there was McLean. He stuck out there, though. Now good stick by Amois. It'll be Huckett using the big frame to keep going. Butler's there, too, for help. Huckett gives it to Butler. Now it's going to be Kiersey back to 5-on-5. It'll be Huckins again to Butler with space. Shot on tip. That one just wide again. Trickling off the deflection. Just missed the goal of Patrick Lever. Now Pierre Noel chops that one out. Isaac Voss back for the Islanders with space. He fires that one all the way up. But that one off the stick of Matty Butler and into the netting with 3:04 left to go. A fantastic look on the power play for the Islanders. But they just couldn't finish any of their chances. Now back underway. It's going to be Da Silva. Shot on. Good save, Boudreaux. Stretching to make that glove save count. It will be Bell. Aruna's behind the defense, and he has it now. In on Da Silva, trying to push him out of the way. Cutting in. Shot. Rebound. Scores! Well, we talked about it earlier in the game. The Islanders looking to add size to their squad, and that's what they do here. And they're proving that it's working. Andre Maruna pushes his man out of the way, drives towards the goal. Couldn't get it to go on the first one, got it on the second try. Isles up 2-1. Fantastic play there by Maruna. Just haven't seen that much from anyone in an Islanders jersey over the last couple of years. You've seen it even in the NHL. They need size to win. That's what they're going for. And right now it's working. Here's a Kuchta. High shot. Good save by Boudreaux. Fantastic goal by 7-1 in black and white. Now here's the Sea Dogs again. A Kuchta. Down low. So Maruna from Bell. And here's another opportunity. Nicholson gives it to Walker. Walker walks in. Shoot. Good save there by Lever. He's able to get the shoulder to that one. Topolnitsky will throw it down low now. It will be Romeo. Along the half wall. Who gives it to Topolnitsky again? Another shot and scores! Anton Topolnitsky from the point. The Islanders cycle the puck around. And that's back-to-back opportunities for the Isles. And it goes in on the long D-bomb shot. 77. We'll get his name onto the score sheet here. So Topolnitsky gets in on the fun with a long shot in. Lever couldn't see with an Islanders and a Sea Dogs player down in front of him. And just narrowly missed them both and was able to sneak in. Low netting. Now here's Šimek for the Sea Dogs trying to get one back after being a 1-1 game for so long. It's 3-1 now with a minute left to go here in period number two. And now Campbell will get stopped up in front of his own bench. Wait for help. Butler will come in for that. Puck gets knocked up into the air. Butler has it now. Waits for help. Horth is offside. He gloves it down. And we're going to have a whistle on the play with 37.7 left to go. Now back and off on their way. Sea Dogs trying to get one here before the period end. Boudreaux doesn't want to hold that one. He'll steer it into the blocker side corner. To his right. Now it'll be Maruna up again. He has Huckins with him. Campbell's going to go off. They're getting a high stick. It's now going to be Maruna again down low trying to bank one home, make something happen in front with 10 seconds left. Sea Dogs are going to try to come back the other way, but that attack gets stopped by Lane Hinkley. And they're content to waste the rest of the clock here as time winds down. That will do it. The Islanders are able to get going after a power play tally from Noah Reinhart that made this game a 1-1 game. The Islanders get goals from Andre Maruna and Anton Topolnitsky. We'll take a quick 15-minute break, and we'll catch you back here for period number three, where the Islanders look to close out their preseason home away from home with a win. Welcome back to Charlottetown Islanders preseason action here, this time from the McLaughlin Arena. For period number three, we have the St. John Sea Dogs down to your right for this period. Patrick Lever in goal for them, stopping 30 out of 33 shots. And to your left, the hometown Charlottetown Islanders, Nico Boudreau. Off to a hot start here in this one. Fantastic first 40 minutes, including a penalty shot save too. And he has stopped 21 out of 22 shots that he has faced. Puck drop, and we are ready to go here. And here we go. Tie up off the draw, eventually falls down to the Sea Dogs. And drifts in on Boudreau. It's where Toplinitsky will pick it up. And he'll begin to wheel before that one gets poked away from him. It will now be Kiersey back behind the cage. He has company there with him. Kiefer Lyons, former Islander. Now in St. John. And he has the puck now. Tries to dish that one across. Eventually he'll get it back. It's going to be Toplinitsky with the backhand shovel into the glass, trying to get that one out, and eventually he does. To Matty Butler, who will chip that one across. It'll be Horth trying to go to Butler. Instead, he goes to Romeo. Romeo chops that one back inside, but Ionello's there first, and he's going to pick it up and wheel. He'll get on his horse, hand it off to Tivy, cutting inside. Quick shot high up on Nico Boudreau, but he made the save, and he'll put the blocker hand onto that, shake the snow off. And he'll be all set to go here once more. 19-10 remaining. It will be the Sea Dogs. Now Reynolds down low, spins off his man Hawkins. Bilodeau stops. That one hops back out in front, but stopped up eventually by Walker. Now Reynolds looking for Mateko. Couldn't find him there, though. Bilodeau trying to dish one off to Reinhardt. That one went off the heel of his blade, and it eventually went over to the Islanders. Maroon went to Campbell. Campbell went to Hawkins, and Hawkins has it now in the corner. Now it's going to be Campbell. Ross Campbell trying to chip that one forward, get something going. Isaac Voss as it pops up to him, lays one into the glove side corner. Duguay's going to step in there. Elects not to play the body. Tries to go and get the puck deep. He does that. Reinhardt will move that one around to Da Silva. Sea Dogs now looking to push it up ice as the captain Reynolds here will flip that one in, and Isaac Voss will touch it down and fluff it up and get it ready to go again. Voss will drop that one off to Duguay, who gets it back to Voss. Voss now looking up ice to Michaud, couldn't connect on that one. They're going to have to go again. It'll be Duguay again to Flanagan. Flanagan tries to cut through his men. Voss tries to get off. He can. He has to come back onto the ice because of that turnover. Now Voss gets a chance to go. It'll be Flanagan with Bell and Michaud. Michaud walks in late. Shot on. Penalty. And it's going to be on the Islanders. And it's going to be a slash. It's going to be Kean Bell heading to the box for 2 minutes for a slash. That's going to give the Sea Dogs yet another opportunity here to get back into this hockey game. As that top unit comes out once more, they'll try to get another goal. Noah Reinhardt out there. He's the one who has the lone Sea Dogs goal so far that also came on the power play. Here's Ellie down low. It goes. Mateko to Bilodeau. Finds the goal scorer, Reinhardt. Bilodeau again up top to Ellie now, or Reinhardt rather, excuse me. Bilodeau shot in that one off the glass and back over towards Mateko. He'll hop over his stick and Bilodeau's and back down to Patrick Lever. Reinhardt will pick up some steam there. Mateko drops it off. Bilodeau steps into one, drops it over. One-time score! A blast from Reynolds at the top of the faceoff circle. Beats Boudreau as he was lunging to his glove side. Couldn't stop that train. And it's a 3-2 hockey game. The power play for the Sea Dogs is keeping them alive right now. So the captain, Peter Reynolds, he helped set up the first one. He'll get the second himself. And that's where we are now. 3-2 is the score. We're back to 5-on-5 hockey. Here comes Horth into the zone, bodying his way through, tries to shovel one on the goal. Traffic in front of Lever. That one misses the mark, though. Now Michel, more traffic in front. Shot on off the shoulder of Lever. Back behind the net it goes. High stick in on St. John, waved off. Now the Islanders have possession. That one is thrown away by Conrad at his head down. Didn't look where Michel was going. It's going to be a Kouche looping back. Fire one down there, but it's going to be now Tivy and Ainella. Back to Tivy. Here's the Islanders trying to move that one back up ice. Butler's content to backhand that one and head off for a line change. Lever will come out of the cage and stop that one up for McLean. That one finds its way back to the Islanders, though, and eventually they'll start the dump and chase again. McLean, first one back for it. He'll look up ice. Nice breakout there, but getting a stick check was Reed Calder. Keeping it onside was Huckins. Now Campbell trying to set something up. Ross Campbell in the zone. Turn to fire looking for Huckins. Just couldn't have the stick down in time. Could Cole Huckins. There's Beveridge now. Tries to move in. Maruna, one of the Islanders' goal scorers. Well, put a stop to that. Kiersey will scoop back for it now. So that one hops out right by Boudreaux. He had to be careful there. Here's Huckins again. Try to kickstart something here. It's Campbell will lay that one off to Marcus Kiersey, who moves back in. The sophomore defenseman here for the Islanders will throw one in deep off a skate and below the goal line. It's going to be Maruna. Down low for it. Still now, McLean backhands out in the Calder. He'll go off the boards and outside of the zone, and he'll head off for a line change while the Islanders will try to keep the pressure on. It's going to be Huckins and Michel, the only two that stayed on. Other 3-1 off for a line change for the Island. Michel, as it looks rink wide. That one hopping over the stick of Conrad. Now in front it goes. Conrad still will loop that one down. Be McLean. McLean makes that breakout pass look easy over to Benoit. Benoit will chip that one inside of the Islanders' zone. That's where Walker will eventually get the turnover and go back the other way. That's Bell, rather. Bell into the zone. Shot on that one off the pad of Lever. And back up top it goes past Isaac Voss. It'll be Flanagan, the first one to it, who then drops it for Voss. Bell wants it. Instead, Voss is going to look the other way, give it to Flanagan, who enters into the zone and scoops that one back behind the net and the goal line. Now Bilodeau chops at it. Boudreaux sweeps it across. DeVos flipping it to Arsenault. Arsenault's that one dribble off his stick. Benoit lines one up for his teammate, but Da Silva couldn't put that one on target. It'll be Reynolds. Just scored a goal. See if he can get another. Arsenault shimmies that one outside of the zone. Walker turns and kind of swats at that one down towards Lever. And he's forced to cover that one up with the Islanders pressing hard on him. 13-18 now left to go in period number three here from the Bell Lion Center. Topolnitsky now, who rims out and around. Romeo looks up ice, that one canceled off. Romeo still, Butler now has it behind the cage. Butler, Tivy, that one looped in down low. Now behind the crease it goes. Mateko chips it for Šimek. He wants it back. He doesn't get it. Tibby will have to backhand that one around. Bodies flying everywhere here at the McLaughlin Arena. And that one off the blocker lever. Back behind the crease it goes again. Now still behind the net. It's Mateko. It's turn to fire there and a score! How about that for a fast-moving play, says Michael Horth. After the puck bounces around for a good 30 seconds behind the net, Horth gets it out front for a second turn to fire. And a five-hole tally for 27 in black and gold. Well, the Islanders regain the two-goal lead. Give themselves a little bit more breathing room as Horth. Earlier in the broadcast, I said I like the strength that he was using. Used it to power his way out in front as he slots that one in on Patrick Lever. Now here's Akush. Chops one in all alone. Quick shot in. Scores! Back again. Back and forth hockey. It's going to be Beaulieu. Slotting one into the low glove side corner. The man unmarked. And Jacob Beaulieu gets the Sea Dogs back. Just like that. No one in a black and gold jersey around. And he makes no mistake there. Nico Boudreau can't do much on that one. But he stopped a penalty shot. Couldn't stop the mini breakaway. Might have gotten a piece of it, but either way, it ends up in the back of the net as the Sea Dogs send that one for icing, and Voss takes a check after there. Doesn't like that very much. I'm sure that there's some communication on that. So Horth gets the Islanders' two-goal lead back with a sweeping five-hole rip. And then just seconds after, Beaulieu gets a chip pass in. Beauty of a chip pass. Didn't catch who it was. But floated right into Beaulieu, wide open. And makes no mistake there. And we're going to come all the way back down here for an icing call to the St. John Sea Dogs. End of the ice will be Michaud, who gets it first off the draw. Pierre Noel's in hard on him, and it'll be Flanagan now driving it for Michaud in front. Bell could tuck that one past Lever. As Duguay. Now Flanagan. Moves that one in, draws a penalty, does Flanagan. And it'll be Beaulieu. What a shift here for Beaulieu. Matt McLean getting a secondary assist there on that Beaulieu goal. Always good to see the Island guys producing. Maybe not whenever they're against the Island teams, but nonetheless. So quite a shift for Beaulieu. Scores and levels Voss after the whistle, then takes a penalty on the span of 50 seconds or so. And now the Islanders are going to have a power play here. And it's Bell. Wins it off the draw. Kiersey sends that one over to Michaud. Over to Campbell streaking in. Headspace. Good stick by Mateko, though, to take away that lane. Fleck the puck into the corner. Now turn to fire there is fanned on. Kiersey has it up top the point again. It'll be Bell. Over to Kiersey, has a man open. Michaud wanted the one-timer, was in the wheelhouse. Backdoor feed to Bell. That one couldn't settle down for 29 either. Now here's the 2-7s. Kiersey and Reynolds. He dives for it. Here's Reynolds in alone. Flipped over the goal by Reynolds. Tried the McDavid. The cross side of the net, little shovel over the shoulder. But Reynolds ripped it high. And Kiersey got bailed out. It'll be Lever watching that one into the corner. As the Islanders try to press here, that puck hops out to Kiersey. He'll be able to settle this one down. As now Bell. Tries to sell it down too, but Bilodeau steps up and he'll just pound that one all the way back down to Boudreaux, where Kiersey will come back to collect. It'll be Huckins. Dance around his man, drops it to Romeo. Back door open was Butler. Romeo went for the shot, didn't work out. And Romeo again. To Huckins. Kiersey now. Gives it to Huckins. Shot on, that one blocked. It'll be Maruna behind the cage. To Kiersey. Now Huckins again, good save lever. Moving to his side. That one took a weird hop off the stanchion. Kiersey able to keep it in the neutral zone for the time being. As now here, Matty Butler into the zone. Still Butler. Finds Huckins with space. Shot on that one. Just wide of the blocker side. Michel's back. He'll hammer that one in for Huckins again, who tries to lay it off for Romeo. Romeo's late getting there, though, and Ellie will get there first for the Sea Dogs. Puck hops out to Conrad in neutral ice as Conrad will scan, try to find an option. That one gets tipped and shimmied into the zone. 9:20 left to go here in period number three. Now here comes Beveridge up the ice. Talked about him earlier. Second round draft pick for St. John. Benoit gets it now. Shot on. Good save. Rebounds out in front. Conrad does a fantastic job tying up Danny Akush. As Arsenal tries to break free with it. It's a high stick up on McLean. McLean gives him a whack back, and now Beveridge tries to bring it free, but instead it's going to be Arsenal coming back the other way. McLean gets his stick in the way, hops up top to the point though. Hinkley with a shot on. That one gets tipped in front. It's loose down low. Batting away at it are the Islanders, but they just can't get one to fall. That was Conrad down there, I believe. Or no, Nicholson rather, as Lever will let that one continue to play. He wants to keep going. 8:30 left to go. Benoit has it now, tries to chip it up ahead. It will be the Sea Dogs. To Akush now. He'll turn and fire that one, and Sea Dogs will go for a line change and some new blood here with 8:20 left to go. A minute gone by that fast already. Here is Lyons. Gives it off to Bellman. Moves cross ice. It's going to be Amois. Amois tries to cycle one down low. Hinkley's going to be the first one to it, though. That one took a hop off the stanchion and went right to Kiefer Lyons. Now Lyons trying to set something up, and said the Islanders step up. And here comes Michaud. Chips one around Bielida. He has two Sea Dogs on him, though. Michaud, first one there, waiting for help from his squad. In front comes the puck, and a jam play there. Sees Lever down and ready, and he will make the save. And carry on for a whistle. Sea Dogs trying to get this game all square. 4-3 is the score right now. That was the final score in last night's game versus Halifax, where the Mooseheads got the winner in Rustico. Now here comes St. John. Going to fire one in towards Boudreaux. That one never found the target. As Toplomitsky will pick it up, give it to Campbell. Campbell crosses over the blue, dances his way in, but he is boxed out. And that'll give the Sea Dogs to break themselves. Here's Reinhart. It's Reinhart, Reynolds, and Mateko. Sea Dogs top lines out here. Mateko tries to direct one towards the goal. He does, but Boudreaux had that all sealed up. Bielodeau chops that one away from Campbell, delays the Isles breakout a little bit. Campbell thought about going for it. Then he goes for a line change. As the Islanders had six men on the ice there again for 5 seconds or so there. That was pretty obvious as well, but they get away with one here. As now here comes the Islanders. It's going to be Horst stepping in, shot. That one off the blocker of Lever into the right-sided corner where Voss is now. Shot on Lever, dives to make that stop. Awkwardly now, people in front, Lever down again. Horth trying another, spinning the fire, this time on the backhand. Lever able to get that one right into the crest of the sweater, and he's going to hold on to that for a much-needed whistle. Hinkley off the drop, trying to cycle that one in deep. Voss playing with Hinkley. They played a lot together last year. See, before Voss got injured. Now kind of just rotating through with the seven defensemen here tonight are the Islanders. Get as many looks at as many people as they can. Now Flanagan will step into the draw here against Ellie. And Anthony Flanagan will pull that one back for the Island. It's going to be Kiersey now trying to move that one up. Instead, Sea Dogs trying to push their way back into this one here. It's going to be Benoit behind the crease. Past the goal line here now. Diving to get that one out is Bell. Sea Dogs entering once more into the zone. Tivy watches on as Ionella will set this one up. And now Ellie brings that one down to Akush, centers it out in front, but that one wouldn't fall. Now Kiersey chops it up. That one stays inside of the Islanders zone, though. Kiersey needs off. He lost his glove. He gets off, and on comes Michel. Ionella to Ellie at the blue line. Dishes one across, no one there. There's three gold sweaters, though. So the Islanders get a free break from that. 4:30 left to go here in period number three as Campbell enters into the zone. He has Maruna with him, and Hawkins shot on that one. Wouldn't fall. Campbell gets up again, tries to throw another one towards the area, but that one wouldn't settle down for Ross. Now here's Bellemare, beats the icing. Centers one out in front, but that one wouldn't settle down this time for St. John. And after all of that, it's going to be a delayed offside call on the play. And we're going to have to come all the way back here into the Islanders' end of the ice as they tried to kickstart an attack there. Preserve this lead. Final 4 minutes here. Offside again. So they're going to have to retreat and go again. Romeo in on that puck. Butler intercepts. Now in on Bilodeau. One-on-one. Romeo's going to try to come and help out. Instead, boxing out. Butler is Bilodeau. Puck comes up top to the point. Hinkley fires one in wide. That one missed the mark. Now it's going to be a standstill here and a pileup in the corner. Throwing that one back. Lee Beveridge looking long and up the ice to Schimmick. Beautiful pass, beautiful reception. Schimmick walks in, shoots. Great block by Horth. Another try. That one, bad angled shot. Schimmick gets leveled there by Hinkley as Boudreau makes a save. Now Beveridge. Back up top again, Bellemare. That one cross ice feed. Horth gets in the way of that one again, and he's just content to flip that one out to center ice. Get two Islanders off here. As two new ones come on. Be Nicholson and Arsenal to come on. Now we'll get that one swept around. Islanders scrambling here. Half the group dead tired. Arsenal doesn't know where that one is. It's past him. And That's going to go for icing, I believe. And with 2:42 left, we're going to see the resilience here of this group. It's Reinhardt. Shot on. What? That one never got to the goal. Tivy to Ionello. Back to Tivy up top now. He'll be the power play. Watch Levers. 2:30 left to go here. He's still in the net. Up top to Tivy again. That one's turned over. Looking to get that one to Arsenal. It's Nicholson. He fanned on it though. And back down. They come. Here's Tivy. Across the blue. That one intercepted by Michaud. Toplomitsky hands that one over. Now it's going to be Walker for the Islanders. Gets stripped by Mateko. Ionello, 2 minutes left to go, a minute 20 seconds. Or 120 seconds, rather, excuse me. As Ionello stands behind Lever, still inside of the goal, is Patrick Lever. Reynolds has it now across the blue. Still this first group out. That one gets off of Michaud's skate. Now they're going to come back the other way. Lever still in the goal. As that one gets floated on, Lever doesn't want to play it. And with a minute and 32 seconds left to go, we are going to have a D-zone faceoff for St. John, which is what I'm sure is the last thing that they would want right now. Huckins down for that draw. Loses it though. St. John will win and it'll be Pierre Noel trying to get that one up to Lyons. Couldn't do so. Gets dropped back onto him. Lever waiting for a controlled possession to head to the bench here for St. John. Now here's Bilodeau. Dishes one off. Lever has to come back though. Can't get a clean zone entry here. Now Benoit. That one tipped off, no icing on the play. Michel skates right into Huckins before eventually getting it to Campbell. 54 seconds left. Huckins into the zone. Islanders playing keep away now. Are going to try to at least, but doesn't go to plan. Benoit stops up, looking wide for Lyons. That one gets caught up, though, in Bilodeau. And back the Sea Dogs will have to come. Now a shot on. It will be Huckins, who gets a deflection there, trying to send that one in deep. Campbell content to just waste some time and loop that one back into the neutral zone for Isaac Voss, who will dump that one into Lever, who's still stuck in his net, then puts it on a platter for Campbell. Campbell gives that one to Butler. Up at the top of the zone, Matty Butler will make his way down. And he's just going to stay along the outside. There's Matt McLean, who rubs him out into the wall. 5 seconds left. Here's Reynolds. He'll have to shoot it fast. Reynolds tries to dish one inside. Romeo gets in the way of that. And as Hinkley makes a big hit on that play on Peter Reynolds, Noah Reinhardt will come to the exception of that. And Hinkley has his gloves off. That's not what you want to see, obviously, the new rules. I don't want to get into that or my thoughts on it or anything like that. But the good news is that the Islanders escaped this one with a win. 4-3 is the final score of this one. Nico Boudreau picks up a win here. A very well-deserved win, in fact, for Nico Boudreau. So final score, as we mentioned, 4-3. Islanders goals coming from Lucas Romeo, Michael Horth, Andre Maruna, and Anton Toplomitsky. So that's all that we got for you today. A happy win for the Islanders and a happy day for most of the fans here at the Bell Alliance Center. On behalf of myself, Luke Much, and the whole crew at Universum Media, we thank you very much for watching, listening, tagging along, and we'll see you at the next one.